Tonight, from First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, Ohio, it's a special prime time edition of the NFL on EA Sports. Jalen Hurts and the Cleveland Browns taking on Mac Jones and the Cincinnati Bengals.
We are just a stone's throw away from the Rock and Roll Hall of Fame as we get set for football at First Energy Stadium in Cleveland, Ohio. This was the scene a few minutes ago. The dog pound in full roar as their Browns emerge from their tunnel. They're ready to go as they get set to match up with the Cincinnati Bengals. With Charles Davis, as always, I'm Brandon Gaudin. Charles, you talk about storylines in this one. I think it begins and ends with our two quarterbacks, certainly two of the best in the business.
And nowadays, I don't think you can get by for long periods of time without a top-flight quarterback. The way the game is played, with all the responsibility he has and how the game flows through him, if he's not on the top of his game, your team's not going to benefit at all.
And out a little across the 25 to the 27. Now on the return here, we've got an injured player down there. We'll check on his status when we get back. First carry for Christian McCaffrey. McCaffrey with a first down and more. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. If you start assessing what went wrong last week, Charles, in their loss, had nothing to do with the ground game. They ran it well.
And you also have to say to yourself as a team, don't go away from what worked. That's not the reason the game was lost. Running the football over time, when you do it consistently, usually translates into wins.
And they're hoping to do it consistently here. Well, one unit I know you want to watch is that offensive line. If they keep clearing holes like that, it could be a long night defensively.
No doubt about it, because when they are in sync, as we're seeing so far, when that continuity is there and you can see that they're playing off of each other while controlling the defensive front linebackers, you're exactly right. It could be a very long night for the defense because someone's going to run for some big yardage.
The numbers for McCaffrey last week. 17 carries, 101 yards, and a score.
And well-liked by his teammates. In fact, I got on good authority, even though I'm not an investigative reporter, that in their team meeting this week, the offensive line stood up and said, "Coach, we've got to have better yardage for this guy. He's number 9 in the league. He's got to be in the top 3 before the season's over. Let's run the ball."
A loss of a yard, and it brings up 4th. And on their first drive, the offense staying out there. They're going to go for it on 4th. Here we go with McCaffrey. And boy, this is going to be close. That mark looks a little short, and he didn't get there. Here come the Bengals now to take over. Christian McCaffrey unable to get to the marker. And this defense holds firm here on the opening drive of the night. So first and 10 now from the 30. Throwing Jones. Quick hitter here, it's complete. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Clock rolling as we hit the midway point of this first quarter. Now Jones. Wright's got it. So give him 5 yards there on the pitch and catch, and it'll be a second down. Looking to throw, Jones. He dumps it to Eckler underneath, and he is down at the 48. A pickup of 4 that started at 48-yard line and ended at the other. They'll run for the first time with Austin Eckler. And that one going nowhere for on the start as he's met in the backfield and goes backwards. That'll back him up 2 yards and also bring up fourth. The punt team on now as Pinion sends this one away. That one sails out of bounds. The side judge will walk it off. And he says it went out of bounds at the 9-yard line. Nice punt. The Browns drive about to get started. They had a great drive going last time. They were moving the ball. And then all of a sudden, it just stalled out. So we'll see what they can do here, Charles.
And it's always easy to second guess when you don't get it on a fourth down try. But they had to like the feeling that they had going on offense. They want to continue to see if they can capture that again on this drive and maybe get in the same position.
Yeah, and that's, I mean, like I said, they were moving the football. It's not like they went four and out. So I don't think it's a deal where the offense doesn't have confidence.
No, I agree with you totally on that one. If anything, they may have gained more confidence. Okay, they stopped us once. That's all right. Let's keep moving it. Make them do it again.
And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's second down. So now second and 10 after the incompletion on first down. Hurts. Buying time to his left. This is caught. It's Cooks. And all the way in. Touchdown, Cleveland. Brandon Cooks. His second touchdown on the season. And the Browns have taken the early lead. Tucker with the extra point. And that makes the score 7-0. Set now to kick this one away, and off it goes. And this will not be returned. It's a touchback, and they'll begin at the 25. Jones now on first and 10. Catch is made by Hunter Renfrow. And he'll take this to the other side of midfield before going out of bounds.
Well, they obviously red man covers their partner, and he got downfield, broke down the defender.
Made him what do you think, mean by that, Burke?
Yeah, he made him think he was going to run a different route. Probably thought he was going to take it upfield, and then he curls back inside for the completion.
And he is tackled inside the 40, not quite to the 35.
We use the word relentless a lot with guys who are aggressive on the field. In this case, it really fits, doesn't it? How about his ability to break tackles and his feet never stop moving?
And the play goes nowhere. Losing yardage back near the 40 at the 39. 2 yards the loss, second and 12. A handoff as they run the counter play. And again, the run defense stout this time. He maybe gets back to the line of scrimmage, but no more. Call it no gain there, and now they're looking at a 3rd and 13.
I know the scouting report on him is that he doesn't possess the eye discipline to be an elite linebacker. What that means is his ability to read, react, and make a play. But on that one, he looked like one of those guys.
Sanders' kick is good, and they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3. So the margin shrinks there as they get the field goal to draw them a bit closer here in the second quarter.
Yeah, nice snap, nice hold. They just want to keep this game close, so give them credit for finishing that one off with three.
And they'll get him down right around the 25, actually the 26 officially, so a net gain of one there. The Cleveland offense ready to go. Now, early on, you know, Charles, every game could be called a measuring stick game, but I think when it comes within your division like this, it's a measuring stick game with a little extra intrigue.
I would agree with that totally because all division games.
He's got a man complete, Tyler Lockett. And all the way in, touchdown, Cleveland. Tyler Lockett, his first touchdown of the new season. And the Browns are able to strike quickly for six. Tucker able to connect on the extra point, and that pushes the lead up to 11. Those are the kind of drives they like on offense, from the coordinator to the quarterback, the line, everybody. One play drive and into the end zone for six. The return man down to a knee, and this will come out to the 25-yard line. Cincinnati set to take over once again. Their deficit is 11, 14-3, and needing to get something going here as they come up on first and 10. Off the play fake, Jones. Complete to right. And this will be a gain of 5 as he gets it to the 30.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
From the 30 on second down, Jones. Oh, into a sea of defenders and intercepted. Picked off at the 36. And this return is going to be halted right around the 28-yard line. On first and 10, it's Hurts. Steps away to his left. That's going to be caught. And out of bounds all the way down at the 3.
And how nice is it for him to know that when he gets outside the pocket, he's got a reliable tight end he can go to. So he's able to look his way, find his big target.
And he takes this one in for a Brown score. Christian McCaffrey. His second touchdown on the season. And the Browns are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead. Tucker with the extra point. And the lead is up to 18 now. They have the short field and they made quick work of it. Just 2 plays to get into the end zone. The kickoff unit is out on the field and they will send this one away. And there will not be a return here. It's a touchback, and it'll come out to the 25-yard line. The Bengals drive about to get going. And following the interception, we'll see what they can put together on this drive.
I can hear my old college coach right now. He always used to tell us before every game, the team making the fewest mistakes will win. What they're hoping is that last mistake is their only one of the game.
Coaches, that's all they talk about, turnovers, right?
Minimizing those and maximizing opportunities.
And not much to speak of. Call it a 1-yard gain up to the 26. Now Jones on third down. Finding his safety valve here. That's complete. And he'll get nothing out of that one. No gain on the play. And that's going to bring up a fourth down. Here's Bradley Pinion now as he'll kick it away for the second time. Turn there, give him an even 20 yards. And the Browns will take over, first and 10. The Browns drive about to get started. They are just putting things together so well here, drive after drive. They really have captured the momentum, haven't they?
They've taken momentum and pretty much not just given him a jersey, but a seat on the bench as well. Whatever do you need, you've got it, because the way they're stringing things together and creating that distance between them and their opponent, it's really hard to narrow that gap. And the other part is they're taking their spirit away from them, too.
Yeah, now they're just looking to add to that total. They're going to hurry back to the line now. Looking to throw again on second down. Hurts. And he rifles one incomplete.
Had an open man that time and ended up putting a little too much heat on it, don't you think, partner?
Absolutely. Just needed a touch more air under it. Instead, he fired an absolute bullet. And he's going to be stopped here at the 43, and that is not near enough to pick up the first. They're going on fourth down with Hurts. Got his target, Samuel. And past the 35, he'll be dropped a yard or two shy of the 30. They go play action with Hurts. And he'll be taken down by the Bengal pressure. Now the Browns will use the first of their 3 timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half. After the sack on first down, Hurts dancing to his left. He's letting it fly for Cooks. And that going to be incomplete. Good effort there, trying to take a shot, but it's third down. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down. And this is good. He got just enough to clear the crossbar as he drops it in from long distance. And that will stretch the lead up to three touchdowns now. It's a 21-point game.
So everything else has gone right in this first half. Kind of follows that it would for their kicker, too, as he adds three more onto the lead.
Yeah, and the way that this one's gone, definitely not looking like he's going to have to worry too much about pressure kicks late in the game. He can go out there free and easy, just work on his form, and he knocked that one through.
The Bengals drive about to get going. Here's Jones on first down toward the center of the field, but it's incomplete.
And with 25 seconds to go, we'll see how they want to play this.
Throwing again on second and 10. Jones, he rifles one that's intercepted.
Jordan Brooks with it.
And he's able to get it back to right around the 27. They'll throw on first down with Hurts. They'll set up the screen to McCaffrey. And he'll go out of bounds in the red zone just inside the 20. A good first down call as the screen play gets him 9.
Here's second and a yard. Here's Hurts to throw.
And this is caught. Touchdown, Cleveland. Travis Kelce as the first half is winding down.
And the Browns will extend their lead here just before halftime.
Tucker able to connect on the extra point. And a rout is on here in this first half.
So not much time to speak of remaining in this first half as the kick's away.
And not wanting to risk anything here late in the half, he'll just take a knee and they'll bring the football out to the 25. The Bengals drive about to get going
as he'll take over with just 13 seconds to go before the break.
They'll indeed try to run it out as they start on the ground. And he'll just push his way forward for a few as the clock will run. So we've come to halftime after a very one-sided beginning to this one. As we'll head down to Orlando, that's where we find our man Jonathan Coachman at our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach!
Okay, Brandon, thanks very much. Welcome in, everyone, to our EA Sports Halftime Report. Let's get you caught up on what's going on around the NFL. We'll begin up at Bank of America Stadium in Uptown Charlotte, where you see the final score there. Lamar Jackson, 3 touchdown passes as his guys bounce back from the defeat on opening weekend. From there, we head up to Foxborough to check on the Patriots at home at Gillette Stadium. And they were winners in that ball game over the visiting New Orleans Saints. Patrick Mahomes, a touchdown pass in the victory. And then finally, a good one on Monday Night Football to wrap up the week between the Buffalo Bills and the New York Jets. Meanwhile, in our game, it's been a back-and-forth first half. Who can put it together in the second half? For the answer, we turn it back over to our broadcast team of Brandon Godden and Charles Davis.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number 3. The Bucs set to get the football first, and they trail here as we get started in the second half.
And this will not be returned, so the second half begins with a touchback.
The Bengals drive about to get going.
And they have a mountainous deficit looming in front of them. It was really, Charles, a disaster of a first half. So where do they go from here?
Well, first thing they have to remember is that what's done is done and there's no going back. And now you have to play this drive by drive. Obviously, come back in this spot, pretty unlikely. But you still have to go out, take pride in your work, and try and put something together here in the second half.
On second and 7, Jones throwing middle, and it's complete. And he's taken down, but able to slip across the 35. So here's a first and 10 at the 38.
And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's going to be stopped up quickly here. Just a yard up to the 39. Here's second and nine, just a yard on that last run. Now a handoff here to his running back. And he stopped immediately there. No gain on the player there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a third and nine situation. Back to throw. Jones. That is caught by Lamb. And taking it across midfield and just shy of the 40.
Well, maybe this offense has learned something from watching their counterparts work. I'm wondering if their coaching staff said, let's do what they've been doing the entire game because that's worked well. This offense, they have not looked particularly good all game long. But a nice throw there for a good game and a first down.
And brought down, but not before they're inside the 25. 19 on the last play, 19 more here, and another first down. And to give this time to the tailback. A strong broken tackle on that one. And then they get him to the ground just shy of the 15. The first down run got five. Here's second and five. And he'll give it here to his running back. And he's able to work it here to the 8-yard line.
Not too many offenses want to turn down long drives, but when you're down what they are, they've got to pay it off with some points.
They'll try and run for it on first and goal. And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. A good run of 6 yards there. Gets him closer to the goal line with second down coming up. They'll try to run this one in. And he's able to break out of one tackle, but then quickly brought down. The ball mere inches from the white line on third and goal. They'll try to run this one in. And he will take it on in for a Bengals touchdown. A great effort there. His second touchdown on the season. And the Bengals are able to draw a bit closer. Extra point up and good by Sanders. And that'll cut the lead back down to 21. Now after the touchdown, ready to kick it away is Sanders. Fielded just outside the goal line. And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Jalen Hurts in this offense trotting back out. And a trio of touchdown passes so far. They've got the lead as well. All is good in their football world at this point.
And it's so much fun for our colleagues, right? Think about our producer, our director, everyone putting together these shots. Wouldn't you love to be in the truck right now to hear him calling for it? Give me that one, give me that one, give me that one. And we just saw three beautiful touchdown passes.
Now he's looking for four. The Cleveland offense ready to go. And they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
One quarter remains here on a Sunday night. We'll return with more after this. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports. Play action. Here's Hurts. Caught. Kelce, left side. And able to get this one across the 45 before he's brought down. On first down, this is McCaffrey. And this one goes nowhere. Losing yardage on the play back at the 46. Off the play fake, here's Hurts. He gets it to Cooks. And he's got another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Bengals 28. Still throwing the football here, even with the big lead.
Yeah, I know you and I came up in a different era, and we think about sportsmanship and all that. Other people think about fantasy points and getting their numbers. That's all they care about right now.
A hit as he throws there, incomplete. After the incomplete pass, here now is second and 10. Hurts sets up to throw it. Throw complete right side to Cooks. And he'll be out of bounds as he gets this down about the 21 or 22. They get seven out of that, so they're left with a third and three. They'll try and pick it up with McCaffrey. And he gets this down to the 18, good enough for a first down. Starting to look like this drive, it may be the final nail in the coffin.
Well, this is why you work out so hard, right? This is why you spend all that time in the offseason. This is why you have those OTAs and mini camps for these situations, these scenarios, to run someone into the ground and secure a victory.
Under four to go now as they come up on second down. They'll try and run some clock here as they keep it on the ground. And here he'll get it down to the seven. They'll try to run with McCaffrey. And they'll be driven back here, losing yardage to the nine. That sends him 2 yards in the wrong direction and leads to second down. Richardson. And he'll be stopped just outside the five at the six. After getting stuffed on first down, not much better there. 2 yard gain. This has been a long drive. You got to figure a field goal would be a letdown. Can they convert now on third and goal? Throwing is Hurts. Hard throw, incomplete.
Let's give this defense some credit now. They let the guys get downfield. But when push came to shove, they stood their ground. And now they'll likely force a field goal attempt.
Forced out to his left. And oh, it'll be intercepted. Desmond King picks it. And the Bengals are going to get the football here as the ball will come out to the 20. He got out of the pocket there, was wondering what he was going to do with it, but I think he was calling, his receiver was calling for the ball, wasn't he?
He certainly was a problem. He called for it too late, and when he delivered, they were all over him in the secondary and came up with the interception.
And he's brought down at the 24 after a gain of four. Just 2 minutes remaining here in the fourth quarter of what has been a one-sided affair. So the Bengals in possession of the football here as we get you reset. They're looking at second down now as they search for a consolation score. Meanwhile, Jones' throw pulled in by Renfrow. And they're able to get this one across the 35. Now they got to get to the line quickly. Jones throwing on first down. A good pickup there. 8 yards on the first down completion. And now they're in the hurry up to throw again on second down. Jones, and he'll work it across midfield inside the 45. Again, he'll drop to throw. He'll get this to Eckler. And he'll get it inside the 40 to the 39. They'll contain him to just four. Second down. Oh, and Jones has just thrown his third interception. Jordan Brooks with it. And the Browns are going to take over at their own 28-yard line. For this defense, CeeDee, that's kind of the icing on the cake here as we get to the end of this one.
And didn't you feel that they weren't just going into total prevent there? You know, they had the lead, and sometimes you fall back and you lose your aggressiveness. Not in this case. They were still making a play on the football, and look how that one turned out. They may have salted this one away.
83 yards on the ground for him now as he has gotten better, really, as the night's gone on. Took just one play to move all the way to the 44 as they try again on first down. This is McCaffrey. Just a yard on the pickup there, and it'll bring up a second and nine. Now the Browns will use the first of their three timeouts. That'll leave them with two remaining. We'll be back after this. And across midfield he goes and into Bengal territory. And, oh boy, something you certainly don't want to see. Debo Samuel still down. While the trainers take a look, we'll step aside. And they'll get him down as he's inside the 40. No doubt out. Those are the types of carries they're looking for here, Charles. The lead in the fourth quarter. This is when coaches that have a reliable running game, they breathe a little easier on the sideline.
Yeah, they love the idea that they can take the air out of the football at this point of the game. That means they're really counting on that offensive line, counting on the runners, taking care of the football. Because you're going to tell your quarterback, hey, no time to be a hero. We're not going to throw it here. Just eat up that clock. And if you have the ball, they can't score.
So Cleveland able to come away with the victory here. And it was a bit of a strange game. They were held scoreless through the entire second half, but their first half output, that's enough to carry them to victory.
And that's an odd game to watch, isn't it? Because when we saw the output in the first half, you think to yourself, okay, they've got something working here. They know what they're doing. They'll continue that along. But instead, it's goose eggs in the second half. Fortunately, enough of a cushion and enough defense to carry them home.
So for Cleveland, they at least get the win here to earn a slip.
Come and get me.